Hi, my name is Fred Kohler and I'm a member of the SOLIDWORKS training team. In this video, I'm going to show you how to check your assemblies for interferences or clashes, both static and dynamic. SOLIDWORKS highlights the interference clearly and optionally lists them by component. We'll also look at eliminating them through editing. Let's get started. Let's click Interference Detection from the Evaluate Command Manager. The entire assembly is the default, so I'll just click Calculate. There's one interference listed, and we can click Component View to list the interfering components. The issue is between the TB rack and the TB gear. Let's change the orientation. I'll click the Z-axis twice, and click Non-Interfering Components, Hidden. The gear is moved past the working length of the rack, so click OK. I'll make the column transparent and drag the TB rack upwards into the working length of the rack. If we retest the interference, it should be free of interferences. This also means that the press cannot operate properly because the column is too high. To fix that, I'll double-click the column and change the overall height to 175 millimeters. Next, I'll hide the component insert and do some dynamic interference detection with Move Component. I'll click Collision Detection, these components, Stop at Collision, select Rack, Pad, and Work, and then click Resume Drag. I'll drag down the TB rack until it stops. That's the only clash in this direction, so again I'll click OK. Let's try another drag, again using Move Component and All Components with the handle. The ball end hits the workpiece part, so I'll reduce the length of the handle to 125 millimeters. Further testing shows that there are no more clashes. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, click the link in the description below to access more great content.